Madam Chair, tayo po ngayon ay hawak po natin yung letter of explanation ni Mayor Alice at sinight po niya yung dahilan na she's not mentally fit, Madam Chair. Ang sa akin lang, nakakahiya naman po dun sa mga tunay na may mental health condition. I would just like to reiterate, Madam Chair, na seryosong usapin ang mental health at hindi po ito dapat ginagamit na dahilan para magsinungaling. Yun lang po, Madam Chair.
Madam Chair,
maraming salamat, Sen. Nancy. Yes, Senate President Pro Tempore.
Thank you, Madam Chair. May I know if the legal counsel or lawyer of Mayor Alice Guo is present here?
COMSEC is the lawyer of Mayor Alice Guo present at the hearing. It would appear, Sen. Jinggoy, Senate President Pro Temp, that the lawyer of Mayor Alice Guo is not at the hearing.
All right. May I know if Mayor Alice Guo is still in the country? May we inquire from the BID if she is still here in the country?
Could we please hear from the BI? The committee would like to repeat the question to which you answered in the affirmative in the last hearing na nasa Pilipinas pa si Mayor Alice Guo. Siya po ba sa araw na ito ay nasa Pilipinas pa? Or
as we speak.
Kung sakali, umalis na ba siya?
Any rep from the BID?
Yes, please approach a mic. Identify yourself. Good sir. Oo.
Yes. Good morning, Senators. I'm Attorney Homer Arellano po from the Bureau of Immigration. And based po dun sa latest check namin sa records ng Bureau of Immigration, wala pa pong record of departure si Mayor Alice Guo.
Kailan po yung latest check na iyon?
Kahapon lang po, chinek po namin. Tsaka naka-alert na po yung mga airport natin tsaka mga subport regarding her. So kung magpapakita po siya, then we will know po kung ano.
Perhaps attorney, during this hearing, para kompletong masagot yung tanong ng Senate President Pro Temp at ng buong komite, pwede niyo i-check ngayong araw kung as far as the bureau knows nasa Pilipinas pa si Mayor Guo.
Yes po, i-check po namin ngayon, then we'll update po kagad, ma'am.
Salamat attorney. And later po pag administer ng oath ng COMSEC, pakisama na po kayo. Ano po?
Opo.
Salamat po. So yun po yung status.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Madam Chair, I just read the letter of explanation from Mayor Alice Guo, and in the second paragraph, ang sinabi niya, I have already sought professional help, but the medical professionals that I have consulted refused to issue a medical certificate stating my condition for fear that they may also experience the humiliation and ridicule that I am going through. Madam Chair, I suggest that she be attended by a government doctor para siguro malaman natin ang buong katotohanan. And I think this letter of explanation is totally unacceptable. Therefore, I would like to move that we issue a warrant of arrest against Mayor Guo for her to attend the next hearing, kung meron man. I so move, Madam Chair.
Maraming salamat, Sen. Jinggoy. Before the chair rules on the motions regarding contempt and the issuance of a warrant of arrest, and for that the chair thanks the Senate President Pro Tempore. Dahil sinabi na rin po ng SP na before this hearing, no, in public sa media, na he is prepared to sign the arrest warrant. Bago noon, before ruling on the motions for contempt and the motion for additional subpoenas, the chair concurs with Senators Nancy and Jinggoy regarding their estimation of the letter of Alice Guo. The committee is in receipt of that letter of Alice Guo seeking to explain her absence again today. Wala po itong kalakip na anumang medical certificate. So the chair also welcomes the offer of the Senate President pro tempore, binanggit na rin ni SP that the Senate could arrange for a government doctor to attend to her or kahit yung sariling Senate clinic natin dito. And also the chair recalls that in a previous also big investigation, there was a resource person there who actually cited mental health concerns, but she still testified despite her mental health issues asserted by a medical doctor. So samantala, ito pong kay Alice Goa, walang kalakip na anumang medical certificate ang kanyang letter. And while with Senator Nancy, we definitely recognize the importance of mental health, we also really do not want to set a precedent in which mental health is invoked to skirt the obligation to appear before a Senate committee. And with the Senate President pro tempore and Senator Nancy, we find her claims in the letter devoid of credibility. Therefore, before the chair acts on the motions regarding contempt or warrant of arrest and additional subpoena, the chair would just like to make of record that we are in receipt of a letter from the attorneys at law of Mr. Marion Ryan Chua, Edwin Ang, and Julian Linsangan III, saying that they received the email inviting them to appear here, but they are respectfully informing the Senate that they have a conflict of schedule as they are also scheduled to file criminal and civil cases on said date. Rest assured that the cooperation of Mr. Chua Ang and Linsangan will be ready and available at the next scheduled hearing of the Senate. The chair will show the copy of this letter to Sen. Sherwin, because these three invited persons are subject of a motion, one of the motions for subpoena of the good senator. So at this point, the chair rules to cite in contempt Alice Guo or Guo Huaping, and for her to issue the warrant of arrest as moved by the Senate President pro tempore. The chair also rules to cite in contempt Nancy Gamo and Dennis Cunanan. Additionally, the chair rules on the motion of Senator Sherwin to cite in contempt Wen Yi Lin, CMN Leal Guo, Jiang Jun Guo, I hope I'm pronouncing his name correctly, and Sheila Leal Guo, Wesley Leal Guo, and invited resource persons, Cruz Pohante, Alpaz, Ong, De La Serna, and Mendoza.
Yes, I second the motion, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Senator Nancy.